Hello, this is Tom Searcy with 1% Difference, and this week we're going to talk about part three in the four-part series on keeping your biggest accounts. We call this defending your castle. Look, in sporting events, teams always talk about the home field advantage, and they always talk about competitors coming into their home field and they say, this is our house. Nobody comes into our house and wins. Well, you have to have that same attitude about your customers. Your biggest accounts, that's your house. You own that house. And you have to act like you own that house. But who's defending that house when you're not there? Because trust me, your competitors are coming in around the edges and they're getting a chance to talk to the decision makers inside of your customer. So what are you gonna do about it? You've gotta arm those people and prepare those people who are already loyal to you to be able to protect you and fight for you when you're not there. So step number one, I'm gonna give you five ideas. Step number one, know your competitors. Who is knocking on the door? Who's trying to get in? Now, you can't throw them underneath the bus and leave fingerprints, so you're gonna have to figure out a smarter way to do this, and that's gonna be step number two. You need to frame them. All that means is instead of fighting them and saying we're better than they are, you simply say, hey, there's a lot of good competitors out there. These competitors here, they're really best suited to serve companies like, and then to find out what the criteria are. How do we know what the criteria are? Those competitors should be working with companies who are not your company. Help your company, the client that you're working with right now, understand their unique position in the marketplace and why you are uniquely suited for them. Not that your competitors are bad, they're just not designed to serve them. Three, you need to educate your executive sponsors to speak that particular language. It's a separation between your company and the other company, not based upon equal merit. Because if you fight them, you've recognized them as being equal to you. Instead, you're simply saying they're a good company, they do good work for companies like those other ones over there, they're just not us. Fourth, know your competitors' stuff better than they do. See, your competitors are gonna make a variety of claims. And they're going to say a variety of things about you. You need to know what that is in advance, and you need to be prepared to answer charges that are made to you, questions and inquiries that are provided to you, and you have to be able to listen for the subterfuge that's going on in the background. Because if you've looked into an RFP before, or if you've seen an inquiry that's come to you before, you can subtly know the language that tells you which person from your competitors is whispering in the ear of your client, and that tells you that you're vulnerable. And number five, always connect your value to the customer's business issue. Show how the competitor gets the client only part of the way there. You know, it's interesting. You can talk about product, you can talk about quality, you can talk about service, you can talk about price. If we mix all of those things together, that particular value equation, you're starting to go ahead and measure out only at the transactional level. But if we go up to what are the business issues that are going on, you should have the advantage on that particular account because you're on the inside, and you should be able to say the reason that you use us is because not only do we get you part of the way to your business solution that you're trying to get, but we get the remainder of it that other folks can't get. So take these five ideas and go out and defend your castle, because I'm gonna tell you right now, every single day, it's under attack. Until the next time that we get a chance to meet, go out and make the 1% difference.
If you like this video, hit the subscribe button down below and the bell, and that way we'll let you know every time there are new videos that are out there. And you can also visit our website below.